Have you been experiencing the uncomfortable feeling of mucus accumulating in the back of your throat? Well, if so, then you may have what's known as post-nasal drip. This is a common occurrence that happens when the glands of your nose and throat produce too much mucus in order to fight an infection or to provide lubrication for mucous membranes. This ultimately can lead to a cough, sore throat, or the uncomfortable feeling of constantly needing to swallow or clear your throat. The good news is, there are a few techniques that you can use to alleviate these unwanted symptoms, and that is exactly what we are going to discuss in this video. Be sure to watch until the end because there's one that I think will surprise you. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. But the first way to prevent or alleviate postnasal drip is to stay hydrated. More than 70% of the human body is made up of water, which is why it's always important to stay hydrated. This is especially true if you're sick with a cold or certain type of infection. Dehydration causes mucus and secretions in the lungs to thicken up, which makes it more difficult to cough up for removal. When your body is fully hydrated, your secretions are more fluid and less sticky, which makes it easier for them to move throughout the airways of the lungs. It's no coincidence that most respiratory infections occur during the winter months, which just so happens to be the dry season. This means that your body has to work overtime in order to maintain proper levels of hydration. Drinking around 3 liters of water per day can help ensure that your body is getting the hydration that it needs, which can prevent thick, unwanted mucus from building up in your airways. The next method that I want to mention is to rinse your nasal cavity. Rinsing your sinuses is a simple and effective way to alleviate the symptoms of postnasal drip. This is especially true if you think the symptoms are allergy-related. A simple rinse with a squirt bottle can wash out the allergens and irritants from your nasal airways, which can eliminate the underlying cause of your excess mucus production problem. The medical term to describe this type of rinse is known as a nasal lavage. It involves the use of a pre-packed bottle kit and saline solution. Saline is a mixture of water and sodium chloride, which is safe for your body and effective in thinning out mucus for removal. You can also consider trying nasal steroid sprays. An intranasal steroid spray is an anti-inflammatory type of medication that is effective in treating a stuffy nose and postnasal drip. It comes as a small bottle with a corticosteroid solution that can be sprayed directly into your nasal passages. These can be purchased over the counter, and some examples to consider include nasal quirt, rhinocort, flonase, and nasonex. As always, be sure to check with your doctor before taking any new medications because they will know more about your individual condition. And while we're on this topic, you can also consider trying certain prescription medicated nasal sprays. Similar to the nasal steroid sprays that we mentioned, these are also effective in treating a runny nose and unwanted symptoms. With that said, these cannot be purchased over the counter, so you have to see your doctor first. One type to consider is azelastine, which is an antihistamine that is effective in treating allergy symptoms. You can also consider an ipratropium nasal spray, which is an anticholinergic agent that can provide relief for nasal congestion and postnasal drip. Another medication to consider is oral antihistamines. These drugs are available both over-the-counter and by prescription. They are effective in providing relief for a runny nose, watery eyes, itchy throat, and other allergy symptoms. They can also be used to fight the symptoms of postnasal drip as well. Some examples to consider include Claritin, Allegra, and Zyrtec. Again, these can potentially help reduce mucus production and help get rid of that uncomfortable feeling of needing to constantly clear your throat. Pseudoephedrine is yet another medication that we need to mention. It's the active ingredient in a drug known as Sudafed, which is a decongestant that can provide relief for sinus congestion and postnasal drip due to allergies. It works by restricting the blood vessels of the nose and sinuses, which can reduce the production of mucus in the nasal airways. This medication doesn't require a prescription, however, there are restrictions for purchasing, and it is likely only available behind the counter of your pharmacy. One more type of medication that we need to mention is oral leukotriene receptor antagonist. These are anti-inflammatory drugs that help open up your airways to make breathing easier. Some examples include Singulair and Accolade. These are prescription-only medications that are used for the treatment and prevention of asthma. However, they can be effective in treating the symptoms of allergies and postnasal drip as well. Switching gears just a bit, you can also consider using natural essential oils. Using naturally extracted essential oils such as eucalyptus, lemongrass, rosemary, and sandalwood can be effective methods of treating a chest infection. You can use these oils either by inhalation via diffusers, vaping, or by topical application in the form of natural vapor rub. Studies show that aromatherapy via inhalation of essential oils can help treat upper chest infections by diminishing nasal congestion and reducing the spasms that occur with a repeated cough. This may be helpful for treating your post-nasal drip symptoms as well. Another effective technique that you can try at home is to gargle warm salt water. Not only does it help get rid of phlegm, this method can also eliminate germs and soothe a sore throat. All you have to do is mix 1 cup of warm water with a half a teaspoon of salt. The reason that you need to use warm water is because it helps the salt dissolve more quickly, and the warm water feels nice on the back of your throat. Take a sip of the mixture and tilt your head back slightly so that it can wash the back of your throat. Then try to gargle the mixture for at least 30 seconds without drinking it, and you can repeat this process as needed. The sodium helps break up the mucus and phlegm so that you can spit it out or cough it up more easily. And the water provides humidity and lubrication so that your secretions aren't as thick and sticky, which helps with removal as well. You can also try the classic lemon and honey solution. Sipping on a solution of lemon, honey, and warm water is a classic home remedy that is widely used across the world. It's useful in alleviating sore throat symptoms that are caused by repeated coughing and can also alleviate postnasal drip. Studies show that honey reduces cough symptoms because of its antimicrobial and anti-inflammatory properties. Lemon is a rich source of vitamin C that helps strengthen the immune system, and when combined with honey, can provide a detoxifying boost. For an effective DIY concoction, you can take a glass of warm water and mix it with 1 tablespoon of lemon juice and 1 tablespoon of natural honey. Drink it first thing in the morning on an empty stomach for the best results. Real quick guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Millions of people around the world are searching for effective methods to get rid of the symptoms that are associated with postnasal drip. Hopefully the information that you learned in this video can help you do just that. With that said, keep in mind that we are not doctors and this video should not be taken as medical advice. Again, this video is for informational purposes only. But hopefully you learned a thing or two, and hopefully you're now 1 step closer to improving your overall health and thus improving the overall quality of your life. If so, be sure to let us know down in the comment section below. And if you want to learn even more about this topic, we do have a full guide on our website. I'll drop a link to it right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.